president's plan to move terror suspects out of the prison camp at Guantanamo Bay is even more complicated right now. And some are arguing that it really is just too dangerous in the wake of that failed airline terror attack. There are a lot of questions about what happens to detainees once they're released and whether they end up going right back into the business of terror. Our own Brian Toddy is digging into that for us. And Brian, we know, talking with senior administration officials, maybe they're going to have to slow down sending these, releasing these detainees and sending them back to Yemen. What do you know?
Well, Suzanne, U.S. officials say at least one man who was released from Guantanamo is being investigated for possible links to this airline plot. Not clear at the moment whether he was directly linked to the incident, but this is not only drawing attention to the release of prisoners from Guantanamo, but also to their treatment at another place where many of them go afterward. Saeed Ali Shari, he did hard time at Guantanamo Bay. Released in 2007, he's now being looked at for possible links to the failed bombing attempt aboard Northwest Flight 253. That's according to U.S. officials, who caution Shari may not be linked directly to the Christmas Day incident. But he has touted himself as a leader of Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula, which has claimed responsibility for the airline attempt. He's also been through the Mohammed bin Naif Center for Counseling and Care. Named after Saudi Arabia's interior minister, it's a rehab center near Riyadh for captured militants who the Saudi government tries to turn around.
They give him a full presentation on Islam. They give him art therapy. They give him psychological counseling. They give him money afterwards. They help him find a wife. They help him find a job.
And Ken Ballen of the research group Terror Free Tomorrow has spent weeks at the center and interviewed several inmates, including some who he says knew Saeed Ali Shari. To critics who say giving accused terrorists art therapy is a joke, Ballen and other experts respond,
I would argue that on the whole it has been relatively effective. Relatively effective vis-a-vis the politically radicalized activists, if not vis-a-vis the hardcore former Al-Qaeda members.
It's those hardcore militants, experts say, who expose the weakness of this rehab program. It can't turn everyone, and apparently didn't turn Saeed Ali Shari.
Did he con his way through the program?
He absolutely conned his way through the program. Here you see, this is the religion class where the people, where the sheikh here is teaching them how to be better Muslims and what's a good understanding of Islam. He sat through a classroom just like this and told them that he had reformed himself. He told the American authorities that bin Laden was a traitor to Islam. All the while he was conning everybody, he told others he remained steadfast for Al-Qaeda, and as soon as he got out, he would join the jihad again against the United States.
Saeed Ali Shari, according to Ballen and other experts, represents about 10% of the more than 100 former Guantanamo detainees who have gone through that rehab program and are believed to have returned to the battlefield. Now, that compares to overall recidivism figures for Guantanamo detainees released by the Pentagon this year. That report said about 14% of all detainees released from Guantanamo are believed to have engaged in terrorism activity afterwards.
And Brian, do we know if there are other countries that have similar rehabilitation programs?
Yemen, we know, has one. Experts tell us it's not nearly as comprehensive as the Saudi program. We're also told that Indonesia and Libya make individual efforts to rehabilitate individual militants, and they've had some success with that. As a matter of fact, Muammar Gaddafi's son is heavily involved in those efforts.
Okay, Brian Todd, thank you so much, Brian.